You maybe look at me, well, of course you've battled with concussions. You're going headfirst down a sheet of ice at 140 kilometers an hour. What else would you think? We didn't know that. I always thought you had to be knocked out cold. That's what a definition of a concussion was, or actually smack your head really hard. So there was no way that I was concussed. But I was going through seasons in races where we would be in a fog, and we just called it sled head. When you're really fatigued and you're tired and you're irritable, and we think, well, it's just because we're traveling for months on end and you're in a different country every week. Of course, anybody would be tired and irritable, and you're not sleeping in your own bed and you don't have your family around you, not realizing maybe the damage that we're doing. And we're continuously throwing ourselves down that track and making that fog worse. And the season, the 2012-13 season, I no longer was myself anymore. My coaches would be watching me on the camera and saying, why are you doing this? Like, you're actually steering down and creating pressure. And when the corner ends, there's nowhere for you to go but up, and you're falling out. And I had no answers for them other than, well, I must try again. Let's put myself in that dangerous situation again while my brain is fatigued. The ringing in the ears, that's my biggest symptom when things are going wrong. And a zinger, I call it a zinger anyhow, it's a sharp pain that goes from here to here, and it'll stop me dead in my tracks. I see stars, it doesn't matter what I'm doing. We couldn't figure out the consistency pattern of why it was coming, why it was attacking me at that time. I could be putting laundry in the dryer, or I could be working out, and sometimes it would just happen. Had a great workout, lifted a lot of weight. I go do my rehab, my therapy, have my lunch, have a nap, and I can't come out of my nap. I'm so tired, and I shouldn't be. I shouldn't be that tired. And I'm thinking, well, maybe it's because I'm just getting older. Things are getting harder. Everyone talks about that as athletes. And then I spent the rest of that week, instead of being in the gym with my teammates preparing for the Russia Olympics, I was in bed because I couldn't handle any type of stimulus of being in a room with a couple of people talking, or the computer being on, the TV being on. Bright lights really bothered me, and holy smokes, was I ever a grouchy bear. Grouchy, grouchy, grouchy. And probably the pressure on top of me, too, of, you know, this, I don't have time for this. I need to be in the gym. I need to be sprinting. I need to be preparing. It's time sensitive. And I was in a restaurant not far from the Valentis Clinic in Calgary, Main Dish, and a longtime supporter, Jason Zarin, said, you know what, there's this clinic just down the street. I know of some soccer players, I know we're going to hear from a mom tonight, but went there and they had their success story. Everybody has their own success stories, and I thought, why not? Like, I'm at this point, I need to do something about this, and it's, I'm not even, you know, yes, I'm passionate about my sport, but I'm more passionate about my life and being able to interact with my family and not be someone miserable to be around and be able to function, get things done that you care about. So I went in and I had my consult with my physio, one of my teammates, with Dr. Chris Hammer, and I thought, why not? I got to do this. I'm going to sign up. And instantly, I felt a difference. I felt the anxiety and the pressure in my chest release. And I thought, we've got something here on my hands. Like, this is the miracle cure. This is going to give my life back. And I went on for that fall. I went to training the next week, and my coaches, I was in the gym, they're like, you're a different person. All of a sudden, I was back. I wasn't that grumpy bear anymore, and I was really motivated, and I was getting things done. And I went into my third Olympic Games the strongest and the fastest that I've ever been, being an older athlete, which is something I'm really proud of. And feel so grateful that Valentis supported me through those months, that they were there checking in and being such an amazing resource, because sure, I really believe that I probably would not have been at those Olympic Games, and I wouldn't be here with a smile on my face and ready to trudge forward on whatever life has in store for me next. So.